pretty cool. Okay. So another Bowser Jr. in Philly. You already have the best in the world, so kind of interesting dynamic there.
Yeah, and can't wait to see all those locals that have just top 8 with 6 Bowser Juniors.
Oh, okay. Let's calm down for a second.
All right. Okay, so we're going to be getting into this match here. Now, this is whenever I see a Lucario on one side of the screen, I think, how well does the character on the other side of the screen kill?
Yes.
And with Bowser Jr., he has moves that hit strong.
Oh, absolutely.
But I feel like the character sometimes, the fact that he doesn't really have a kill throw, as far as I understand
it. No, maybe a high enough percent, but like not really.
His moves that kill, with the exception of like cart follow-ups.
Yeah. It's like you're saying, like he's just naturally inconsistent. He's not what he was in Smash 4, but that's to be expected. And something very interesting, which we'll be seeing a lot, is how he, Terra Boy, will put out the Mecha Koopa, right, on reaction to Aura Spheres as a means to like challenge it and potentially break it. Beautiful tech read. That was just really great positioning. Terra Boy not really having too many options there, and Vivi gonna go up with a little bit of rage. Up throw, up air, nair. 52.
Yeah. Just take it.
Yeah.
Oh, it keeps going.
You just hold it. I mean, it's all good. It's all fun and games for Lucario because he is a character that will thrive off of this, right?
Yeah.
Obviously. Or so potent. Not gonna connect. Yeah.
And this is the sort of thing where.
Lucario this might kill?
No, not quite.
They buffed it, though.
Yeah. Okay. But the thing is that Lucario is it's so weird because on the one hand, it's a character that you, when you get behind against him, it's so, so scary because you're like, oh, no, now he's at
100%
energy.
Now he's running away with it.
On the other hand, if he manages to take the stock right here, which he still
almost
could.
Off the top.
Oh, man.
A DI looking among us right now. Anyways.
I hate it here. Oh my god, put me back.
Oh wow. Dude, Vivi almost up smashed him off that platform extension. That would have been very clean.
And there
not much Bowser Jr. can do in that situation. Now we have a 3-1 stock game. And I. Bruh, up throw upgraded to 36. I mean.
Going for that down smash, but it worked out from earlier.
Back where I'm from, this is what we call kind of like a next. You know, you kind of use this game as just a little more of a way to gather intel.
It's the real Galaxy Brain thing is to start doing specifically bad habits so they start exploiting your non-existent bad habits.
That's too powerful, dude. But the thing is, too, which I'm waiting for is the fact that Bowser Jr. actually has, like, true 0 to 60s on most of the cast. That kills, I guess.
That was
he can do like up throw, up air, back air, and he'll do like 60 all the time. I get hit by Yoda.
I mean,
like,
this game started with like a 60% combo or something off of a quick up air juggle. But
by Bowser Jr., yeah.
Yeah, but since that point, it's basically been Terra Boy getting little bits of chip damage and then not being able to kill Lucario until 160%.
Yeah, not really taking advantage of the situations where he puts him into disadvantage and, you know, has like, you know, big hitboxes that might kill.
Do you think, against some characters, it's like really good to, like against Lucario, you just fish. You know,
yes.
Like fish for your kill moves. Is that a viable thing with Bowser Jr.? I do know that, I think he has, nice. Like for instance, does he still have cart to up B?
He does have cart to up B, yeah. It's very situational. You can DI it if you're aware and if you're at the right percent, but there are perfect percents to my knowledge. So the way you want to DI it actually is out. It's that way, so you either don't get hit by the hammer, or you at least get the sour spot of the hammer, which will not kill as much. But in that situation, like, you know, like, it's been a year and a half. Terra Boy had a lot of rage. It is Towden City, which does have the smallest side blast zones in the game, so it's a little easier for Bowser Jr. But honestly,
well, it's
I think
also easier for Vivi, as we saw.
Yeah,
I actually liked it, the fact that Vivi was going for a lot of these kill off the side options. You know?
Exactly. Yeah, he was taking advantage of Bowser Jr.'s, you know, low tierness or mid tier. Excuse me, Yoda's gonna yell at me if I call him a low tier. All right.
Okay, then we're getting to the next game now. One thing that was still present in that last game was the Mecha Koopa. You know, that Terra Boy would put the Mecha Koopa down and then just be able to really reliably
hit
Vivi once it was in play.
It's an active little projectile.
Yeah, and it's one that, you know, you have very good awareness of how it limits your opponent's options.
Mm-hmm.
But this time around, we actually are not even seeing that much Mecha Koopa. Instead, he's opting to try and just get in on him.
Which I honestly, now that you mention it, don't really agree with that. Part of the Bowser Jr. game plan is, like, you know, having the Mecha Koopa out there, seeing how the opponent responds to it. There we go. That was a really good jump call out. But you have to understand it works both ways, because Vivi could also have really great item play and could use it against him, you know. Z-drop, combos and stuff, you know, stuff that we haven't seen yet, but it might come out.
Like, do you play around with the potential of your opponent, or do you at least play around what you know that they can do?
You know? Probably what you know they can do, because it's only a best of three. Not too much time to worry about what's not in front of you, per se.
Yeah.
Oh, oh wow. That could have been something. There we go. Oh,
I wonder if so. That is something that is worth keeping in mind. The fact that Lucario has a counter that I assume if it hits that tiny little projectile,
yeah,
it locks on. I believe it even adjusts to the height mm-hmm. of where Bowser Jr. is. So
oh,
we're going to see that now.
Oh, there you
yeah.
go. So that right was, on the money.
Yeah, so that was honestly kind of the reason why maybe he wasn't using Mecha Koopa so much. But at the same time,
yeah.
it's so hard to say. Using it, I think that I don't even know if you can punish. Even if you know he's going to counter and are able to avoid it, I don't even know if you can effectively punish that move. So,
ooh,
yeah.
That was a really great wait by Vivi. Terraboy, he's getting desperate for these kills. Like, the big thing about this game is that you have to kind of almost let the kills come to you, right? Situationally, you put Lucario off stage. He has to grab a ledge here or, you know, commit to an upbeat like that. That's when Terraboy starts to, he needs to break out what he knows, right? But regardless, great awareness on that side B, and we're back to even right now.
Yeah.
Up throw, up air, not gonna find the 0-60, but still good regardless.
Yeah, and okay, that time doesn't get the
dude,
tech chase.
Every time he's in a tech chase, I like feel it, dude.
Ooh. Is he missing these techs on purpose?
No way. I think he'd be just better attack it and like try to like take your space. I like how Vivi opted for the grab there, too. He recognized the situation really well, and that was
so
really great.
I want to briefly just mention, touch on the fact that Bowser Jr., after he uses his up B, mm-hmm. he gets access to a Smash 4 air dodge.
He does, yes. It's very interesting.
I'm pretty sure because I just didn't finish programming this character.
This game is just unfinished, bro. Let's be honest.
At this point, patching it in would be, like, too embarrassing.
It would be disrespectful in a way. Kind of like a slap in the face, like, you know, every other patch. what I really like what Terraboy is doing, though, is he's using the cannonball to cover his way on stage because the falling hitbox and the landing is still active. Granted, he's down, but it's just great to see a player like him like understand as the set goes, oh, here's what I can do. And this jab might kill. Not going to kill just yet. A few more percent, though, because that jab does kill.
Yep. One of the few jabs in this game that really does.
Yeah, honestly. And they just buff Bayos, too, so that kills now, too. So be prepared for that.
Do you know how quickly that kills now?
Like 150 center stage, maybe like 120 like at ledge, around Bowser Jr.'s, I want to say. Ooh, that was very funky. And Vivi opting to play the corner here. Nice.
I think that was good recognition.
Taking center stage slowly, yeah. Taking
realizing
his space, not committing to anything too. Also a great spot dodge. Wow, on reaction too. That's something you cannot see on Wi-Fi.
Okay, 168% on Vivi. Against anybody else, I'd be like, oh, this stock is on its last legs. But considering this is Vivi's Lucario,
this might be
Terraboy who's signing up to die here.
Vivi's been playing this character for years. He knows where he wants to survive, how to survive, how to take advantage of 176% Lucario.
And this is what I was saying before, where Bowser Jr. doesn't really have, in the neutral, ways to
nothing reliable.
Kill.
Not to mention, we are looking at a matchup where, essentially, Jr. has to put up with a charge shot, right?
Yeah.
His toolkit does not,
I will say we've been seeing a lot of back air and forward air, a lot of it lately, actually,
uh-huh.
because it eats the projectile. We've
yeah.
seen that a few times, but yeah, like you're seeing the way that he's throwing out, but even that is
nice.
Inherently risky. Finally cleaning up that stock and taunting.
Oh, okay. He's trying to turn up right now. He needs it, man.
Oh.
All right.
Listen, when you taunt to immediately outspace your opponent, that is meaningful.
There you go. That's the good ladder. That's the stuff. Now, if only he had platforms, might have been able to get a little bit more, but alas, FD strictly test the neutral.
Bruh!
I ain't never seen Yoda do that one. Yo, take notes, Yoda.
That was actually...
That was clean.
That was
just clean.
If he had gone the other way, too, he probably could have converted.
Honestly, I didn't think about that. He maybe could have. So, yeah, maybe something to learn for next set.
Well,
what?
I don't know if we're going to have
he just did a 0-2 status confirm, and he lived. Oh, he was looking for that charge.
Wow, just runs into it and is still able to
this
shield
this is
that
anyone's
smash.
Game right now.
Oh,
no way.
No. They're both deep
dude,
in the red
so
here.
Cool.
That's going to be it. No, it's not enough
no.
still. That was probably percents
next
away from
hit,
finishing.
Next hit, next hit.
Ah, no, that's another hit after all.
Who's going to take it? Oh! He should have F-tilted.
Oh, yes.
No, this is no grab. Come on, Vivi.
That was so smart. that cannon was so smart.
Dude,
but
he has re-grabbed the ledge like four times now.
I think VB's just too nervous to go in there. It was the right call. No,
but he hit the cart. He hit the cart and he lived.
How is this still continuing? That should be it. Yeah.
Good mix. Good mix.
Ooh.
That was... Wow. that was insane. What I love about that is, like, we just saw both these players, although they were getting nervous, that kind of call out is just so confident. That's a last play call out. You save that for the set winner, per se. Because he wasn't – that was a situation – terrible.